Espero que sea lo nomás no lo deja estar, que nomás no lo deja vivir en paz. Que fulano sutano lo está matando, el espíritu que lo tiene celta, que nomás no lo deja ver, que nomás no lo deja estar, que nomás no lo deja vivir en paz. Hay que mandarle al padre que lo venga a curar, hay que mandarle al padre que lo venga a curar. Bendito santo un rompimiento para sanar, bendito santo un rompimiento para sanar, para sanar, para sanar, para sanar, para sanar, para sanar. Sirve pana, ese espíritu inquieto que anda en ese papa. Hay que mandarle al padre que lo venga a curar. Hay que mandarle al padre que lo venga a curar. Bendito santo un rompimiento para sanar. Bendito santo un rompimiento para sanar. Que seas en los cielos, santificado sea tu nombre, venga tu reino, sea su voluntad en la tierra como en el cielo. Danos hoy nuestro pan de cada día y perdónanos.
So Sandino. All right. I already need a break, y'all. What a joy it is to be here and to have been invited by our brother, Damien. Give it up for Damien, y'all. Amazing human being, bass player, and a great dad, as we've been catching up, and I see what his beautiful wife posts about their beautiful, talented daughters, and we're just so lucky to be alive and to be here and be sharing music with you today.
So throughout the evening, we'll be sharing a bunch of different songs from different moments in the history of the band. The band's been together for 30 years. And yeah, thank you. And the next song we're gonna do is called Rooster. And it is, it's from an album called Quetzanimales. And it was us taking a look at urban animals or animals that are in urban settings, which wasn't always the case, and the ways in which humans encroach upon these animals' ability to exist, right? There's songs about coyotes, about pigeons, but this one in particular was, and whoever, I don't know if this happens in San Diego, but in East LA, the roosters are a thing, right? And why is it a thing? It's because people don't just migrate as empty vessels. People migrate as holders of culture and tradition and love and connection to the earth and to animals and to all things. And so the rooster is in so many traditions, and particularly the one that we practice, which is the Son Jarocho tradition from Veracruz, Mexico. The rooster has a particular job, and that is to wake the people up, right? And you can interpret that however you want, right? It can be a literal interpretation, or it can be like, wake the fuck up. Like, look at what's happening around us. Like, let's get our shit together, right? And so that's kind of the way that we're talking about it in this song. So this is called Rooster. Let's just go right in.
Wake up, everybody. Make some noise if you're enjoying this incredible band. I'm realizing how much I miss you guys. Like, we need to make sure that they come back to San Diego more often. I know it took Juan 4 hours to get here, but it usually doesn't take that long, right? Yeah, take the train. I'll come pick you up. This is beautiful. Quetzal, you mentioned the tradition of Son Jarocho and the instrument that's in your hands right now that's not a guitar. Can you elaborate on that and tell us a little bit about Son Jarocho and the instruments that you're playing tonight?
Sure.
And how that crossed, how did that intersection happen in your life?
Yeah. So as I mentioned, the Son Jarocho is a traditional music that is born out of Black people, or people who were forced into slavery in what is now known as Veracruz, and indigenous people coming together and refusing an unlivable destiny and creating these conditions of possibility, conditions of imagining, conditions of thriving in the face of brutality, in the face of the most inhumane conditions. And so, you know, when we first started understanding what this music was, it was incredibly powerful, and it was aligned with the things that we believed and we thought about as a band, as musicians, as human beings, growing up on the East Side, and seeing the connection between those same conditions and the things that we were experiencing as kids, whether it was the decimation of unions by the government at the time, it was Reagan, right? And the ushering in of this new global economy, or if it was, you know, all the police still killing people all over the place in our communities, in our streets, and making it unsafe for us, right? And so the Son Jarocho has always been a part of Chicano rock music ever since Ritchie Valens recorded La Bamba, right? And we could look at that and say, oh, that was a really cute thing he did. He sang in Spanish and, you know, blah, 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 blah. But when we think about it, it was a very important moment. And it was an incredible act of rebellion for a 17-year-old Chicano who was forced to change his name and who came from parents who were migrant workers, who he himself, you know, experienced what this was, at a time where Operation Wetback was a thing, a federal policy. And so imagine what he did in this one act, affirming his identity, affirming his culture, when he could have done whatever the hell he wanted. He already had a hit. The way this industry works is, once you have a hit, it's carte blanche, right? It's always been that way. And so he could have done whatever the hell he wanted. He could have gone and just done his own thing, but he put his community on his back and did this thing that was so incredibly important. And that moment created a pathway for us to be able to express ourselves wholly, where we didn't have to fracture ourselves and be white or be like this or be like that. And that we were living in close proximity and with, along with, and in community with Black people. And that their music was so empowering for us, and that we needed to look for these other ways to articulate our lived reality, because we did speak Spanish at home, because we did eat things that were different, because we did have a style that was different. You know, we could talk about the Pachucos later on, which actually, that's the next song. We're gonna play Lalo Guerrero's song called Chucos Suaves. And so, so all of that, you know, but then La Bamba, okay? When you trace back La Bamba and what it is, it comes from this tradition that has those same sort of rasgos. What's the word for rasgos? Traits of rebellion, right? And so for us, the Son Jarocho has also been that, and we've been able to build relationships with communities down there who have the same vision of taking back this tradition in the way that it was meant to be, which is in the community, right? And we'll have a song about that also later on. Called Fandango Fronterizo. And we have some folks in here that were a part of that, building that space. And so, anyways, so the Son Jarocho is incredibly important to us, and Los Lobos were another another moment of a generation that carried this tradition and held on to it, and we call them guardians. We, you know, people who carry these traditions, we call them guardians of tradition, right? And so, you know, we're really excited to have these instruments, to have access to them, and have access to the information that has been carried across time and space to land in our hands in this very important way, and we don't take it lightly, and we utilize them to tell stories and to push back and to really, you know, make it a point to make sure that the next generation and the next generation, the next generation, and seven generations down, that they inherit a very different world, right? So that's our goal.
Yes.
All right. So, like Quetzal said, mentioned, Chuco Suaves was written by Lalo Guerrero in the 40s. And so it's about these Pachucos, another era of rebellion in brown people in Los Angeles, all over the country, really. But that's what this song, we're going to cover one of his most notable songs, dice, in our way. Dice.
Chucona, las caderas a menear, ella le hace muy de aquellas cuando empiezo a guarachar, y al timbal de los timbales yo me siento petatear. Pachuco suave baila rumba, baila la rumba y la zumba, baila el guaracha sabrosón, el botecito y el danzón. Pachuco suave baila rumba, baila la rumba y la zumba, baila guaracha sabrosón, botecito y el danzón. Cada sábado en la noche yo me voy a borlotear con mi linda Pachuco. Cuando empiezo a guarachar y al contar de los timbales yo me siento petatear. Pachuco suave baila rumba, baila la rumba y la zumba, baila el guaracha sabrosón, el botecito y el danzón. Pachuco suave baila la rumba y la zumba, baila el guaracha sabrosón, el botecito y el danzón. Thank you.
Pónganse abusados, ya los tiempos han cambiado. Usted está muy aguitado, tiene el booty atravesado. Antes de bailar el swing, boogie woogie, jitterbug. I forgot that verse, dude. Se me pasó, perdón. I just wanted to say that I know I messed up. I sang the same verse twice. Maybe I shouldn't have told you, you wouldn't have noticed. Oh. de esta morena mestizo.
Dr. Martha Gonzalez.
We're going to sing about Palestine.
Yeah.
palabra fue mi muro, se ha formado un andamiaje. Derrito con un mensaje del pasado hacia el futuro. Con mi jarana conjuro en la tarima un hechizo, reunidos a ras de piso. Con gusto quiero decir que te vuelvo a revivir en el fandango fronterizo. I know she looks half Thai, half Japanese, but she's Chicana. I'm just kidding, no. She's half Thai, half Japanese from Monterey Park. She's gonna get mad at me. But she's from the east side. Hey!
Chicana by association.
Yeah, me tienen aquí, I need a raise. ¿Sí o no? Sí, ¿ya oíste Quetzal? This is his band. He's always reminding me. This is my band. This is my band.
That's not true. Don't ever say that.
Dude, I say this is my arrangement. I was like, ¿quieres amorcito? I said, okay. That's okay, we could do it your way. I was like, all right. I'm just kidding. No, that doesn't happen.
Thank you.
So every once in a while when we play now, I'm like, wow, we survived the pandemic. We really thought that the world was ending at that time, and I think for a lot of folks, it did, right? And we want to remember them now. But I remember thinking during the pandemic and the Black Lives Matter and all the terrible things we were seeing, I was like, wow. And we were shut.
Black Lives Matter was not one of the terrible things we were seeing.
Yeah, that's true.
It was the response to the terrible things.
Yes. And yes. That's what I meant. I'm sorry. And I remember thinking that we really thought the world was ending, and trying to be upbeat for my son. He was had just turned 15 during it, and he was really scared also. But we wrote this song right before we really hit the deep end of the pandemic, and knowing that it was coming, but it was a at that point, with everything happening, I remember feeling really, you know, have you guys ever seen Rogue One? Okay, you know that part where they did what they could do, and they hugged right before that big wave of, like, you know, they're dying, right? They know, that's what it kind of felt like, and this is kind of the image I was having when these lyrics were written, and it's called Justice Never Dies.
Keep
Beautiful.
I think we have one last one for you. Is that okay? All right. We want to thank you so much for coming out. And okay. So I'm going to let Quetzal talk about this song.
All right.
So but not too long, Quetzal. All right? Keep it short, Quetzal.
Do I talk a lot?
All right.
Tell me the truth, folks. Do I talk a lot?
Oh, come on. Oh, they're being nice. They're being nice.
You would think I was the academic, right?
Yes, yes, yes.
All right. So I'm going to admit it, all right? I was a big fan of Morrissey. And there's this song that I absolutely love called Margaret on a Guillotine. Okay? And it says, the kind people have a wonderful dream, Margaret on a Guillotine. Because people like you make me so old and tired. When will you die?
Damn.
Please die. When will you die? Please die, right? And kind people, do not shelter this dream, make it real, make the dream real. And it's about Margaret Thatcher. Okay, and if you know anything about Margaret Thatcher, okay, so the Smiths, which is really the group that I love, not Morrissey, but when he was in the Smiths, they're from Manchester, and Manchester is a working class province full of Irish immigrants, and you know, a lot of labor organizing happened there, and so on and so forth, and so. And Margaret Thatcher was brutal with them. She brutalized those people, and so they never forgot it, right? And so he wrote this song. And so we were writing our Die Cowboy Die album, and this is actually the song that gave birth to the title of the album, and it's called You Must Die.
As in the mentality must die, the mentality. Shot and squint to look at what you've done. Yee-haw, yippee-o, yippee-o, hi-yay. It's cowboys and Indians, saddle and sleigh. Old time game to justify. All that they can. you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, Damien. Thank you so much, Sandino, Gonzalez Flores, Tailana Enomoto. We haven't mentioned El Único Perez on bass. Quetzal Flores. And my name is Marta Gonzalez, and we are Quetzal. Thank you so much. And Sandino.